fix and learn some of the most popular JavaScript frameworks. As a co-chief kawaii officer at Code Chrysalis, I've been working hard to make sure that we are delivering the highest quality curriculum to our students. It's difficult work, but I'm lucky to work with a top-notch team. Mia's still pretty new here. We were all very proud to watch our students graduate. A very large crowd turned out to see their final presentations, and we finished the week with a delicious home-cooked brunch. We hope you'll join us at Code Chrysalis. Wait a minute, who let that bug in here? Oh, it's a butterfly.
Hi, my name is Yan. I'm one of the co-founders of Code Chrysalis, and this is what we did this week. Students rewrote a utility library that's commonly used. They used test-driven development to create the virtual DOM from React, and they practiced a lot of recursion. They also learned about the value of rapid prototyping through some marshmallows and spaghetti.
Catch your live stream once you're live.
Enjoy it.
Good luck. Whatever's happening here.
Seems like it's good so far.
Seems to be good. It seems. I think it's also like capturing even now because yeah. If I do this, you see the spikes. No, don't. Then the videos are silent. Who cares? Just don't talk.
Hello, my name is Shudo, and I'm a student.
If you want, I can take your morning from you.
This week, so for you to study, now I'm enjoying
laptop
from
this
position.
We
only have 3 days of classes. We also have two sets of speakers. AOP leads the team that pushed Popo, the robot, and Kubo that kept Christian. Anthony is COO of a medical robotics company and talked about singularity and artificial intelligence.
Oh, we also work for
you. Yeah, I should have done that.
Hello, my name is Ilya, and I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. This week we started our final team projects. My team is working on an app that uses image recognition technology to search for similar products on Amazon. The other team is working on a language learning app that uses speech-to-text and translation APIs. We also worked on our job search this week. We met with recruiters from Computer Futures and talked about strategies for interviewing with companies. If you want to improve your hard and soft skills and build cool products in Tokyo, come to Code Chrysalis.
Hello everyone, I'm Yuta, I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. Learning here is really tough, but so much fun. It is week 5, and this is our last full week before the project phase. We'll learn about using GraphQL for API design, and we learn how to set up continuous deployment and integration. Code Chrysalis also hosted 3 meetups this week. The first featured a Google engineer talking about programming language he wrote. The second was a workshop on GraphQL. And the third featured an iOS developer sharing tips for a digital nomad
stream starting the source.
In the next few weeks, all of the students will give a 1-hour technical talk to the public. These events are now posted online. I'll be talking about blockchain technology. Check them out on our Facebook page. I hope you can join.
Yeah, just and then transition.
Okay, or oh, potato. No.
Hey, Pepper.
Also, I just noticed that.
All right, here you go.
Kind of.
This always happens. I just turn off.
Hello, everyone. My name is Pepper.
I think it's actually once you have a stable setup, you should probably not have it on.
This week,
our students took a full day test.
But right now, for the very first transition, yeah, you should probably go to the slides
and apps from scratch.
But like, after once.
Thank you to their
instructor
to talk to the class. The students are working on projects using their drone APIs and will share their apps with the company next week.
So we still have 30 minutes.
We also started working on job preparation. This is a huge part of our program and
continues
even after the students graduate. Kumiko, one of our graduates,
the announcement
stopped by to share some
I
good news. She was hired by
yes,
her dream company and doubled her salary.
Can you try going through your slides and see, make sure it shows up here?
Okay.
Oh, do you want to play it
Hello, my name is Ilya, and I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. This week we started our final team projects. My team is working on an app that uses image recognition technology to search for similar products on Amazon. The other team is working on a language learning app that uses speech-to-text and translation APIs. We also worked on our job search this week. We met with recruiters from Computer Futures and talked about strategies for interviewing with companies. If you want to improve your hard and soft skills and build cool products in Tokyo, come to Code Chrysalis.
Hi, I'm Kani. I'm a co-founder at Code Chrysalis. This week is busy. It's week two, and on Sunday, we held a meetup for people interested in coding and taught basic programming skills. We also gave our students a chance to lead this talk. Every student gave a 5-minute lightning talk about a technology topic in the news. We worked on data structures, time complexity, and sorting algorithms. The students also completed their first solo project.
You've already gone through your slides, right? Remember your acing slide?
Well, what Kani didn't tell you was that it was his birthday.
Acing slide. Happy
birthday!
Hello, my name is Masataka. I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. This week, we worked on small projects where we built full-stack apps in a language other than JavaScript. These new languages included Golang, Ember, and Ruby. We also visited RGA and learned about their approach to business, marketing, and engineering. We are almost done, so we are enjoying the last 3 weeks of class together before we graduate.
Hi, I'm Kani. I'm a co-founder at Code Chrysalis. This week was busy. It's week two, and on Sunday, we held a meetup for people interested in coding and taught basic programming skills. We also gave our students a chance to lead this week. Every student gave a 5-minute lightning talk about a technology topic in the news. We worked on data structures, time complexity, and sorting algorithms. The students also completed their first solo project.
What Kani didn't tell you was that it was his birthday.
Yeah, my parents were mad.
Happy birthday!
Hi everyone, my name is Krista and I'm an instructor here at Code Chrysalis. It's been really busy this week. It's week four for our immersive students and we had a lot of field trips this week. First, our co-founders made a visit to RGA, one of our hiring partners, and met up with Bill, one of our graduates. He's really liking his new job and will be coming back in a few weeks to teach a foundations course for people who are just getting started. So, if you are interested, we still have a few spots. Then, about halfway through the week, we had a special guest.
Yumi is a professional opera singer and trained all the students to utilize breathing techniques to improve their speaking voices. This will be especially important in a few weeks when every student gives a two-hour meetup to the public about their favorite techniques. Finally, we spent the last 2 days of this week at Digital Labs, one of our industry partners. Students teamed up with their employees to learn more about lean startup principles and creating products to Students also put together their first solo projects over the weekend, which required building full-stack applications. This week, we focused on learning one of the most popular JavaScript frameworks, React. In the process, they also learned about managing state with Redux and transpiling code with Webpack. All of these field trips reminded us just how inspiring the technology industry in Tokyo is. In the next few weeks, you'll be hearing from Code Chrysalis students who have come from as far as the US, Austria, and Germany to spend time learning in this field.
So I'm like, yeah, WordPress would be the best word. Exactly, exactly. So, I mean, it gives me.
Hello, my name is Masataka. I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. This week, we worked on small projects where we built full-stack apps in a language other than JavaScript. These new languages included Golang, Ember, and Ruby. We also visited RGA and learned about their approach to business, marketing, and engineering. We are almost done, so we are enjoying the last 3 weeks of class together before we graduate.
Hello, my name is Ilya, and I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. This week we started our final team projects. My team is working on an app that uses image recognition technology to search for similar products on Amazon. The other team is working on a language learning app that uses speech-to-text and translation APIs. We also worked on our job search this week. We met with recruiters from Computer Futures and talked about strategies for interviewing with companies. If you want to improve your hard and soft skills and build cool products in Tokyo, come to Code Chrysalis.
It's still
It's the final week of class for our immersive students. Over the last 12 weeks, they've built a lot of projects and learned some of the most popular JavaScript frameworks. As the co-chief Kawaii officer at Code Chrysalis, I've been working hard to make sure that we are delivering the highest quality curriculum to our students. It's difficult work, but I'm lucky to work with a top-notch team. Mia is still pretty new here. We were all very proud to watch our students graduate. A very large crowd turned out to see their final presentation, and we finished the week with a delicious home-cooked brunch. We hope you'll join us at Code Chrysalis.
Wait a minute, who let that bug in here?
Oh, it's a butterfly.
Hello, my name is Masataka. I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. This week, we worked on small projects where we built full-stack apps in a language other than JavaScript. These new languages included Golang, Ember, and Ruby. We also visited RGA and learned about their approach to business, marketing, and engineering. We are almost done, so we are enjoying the last 3 weeks of class together before we graduate.
Hi, my name is Yan. I'm one of the co-founders of Code Chrysalis, and this is what we did this week. The students rewrote a utility library that's commonly used. They used test-driven development to create the virtual DOM from React, and they practiced a lot of recursion. They also learned about the value of rapid prototyping through some marshmallows and spaghetti.
Yes.
I think Yan will probably.
I was just actually looking at them together, so I'm not sure.
Hello, my name is Masataka. I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. This week, we worked on slow projects where we built full-stack apps in a language other than JavaScript. These new languages included Golang, Ember, and Ruby. Right, we also visited RGA and learned about their approach to business, students, marketing, and engineering. We are almost done, so we are enjoying the last 3 weeks of class together before we graduate.
Their choice. The only difference is that they have to explore it on their own through code.
Konnichiwa, my name is Christian. I am a student at Code Chrysalis.
To go, but not least. So really excited that this will be your first time speaking.
Yeah, right.
In Japanese or English?
English and in Japanese also.
For both. Okay, so first time speaking, period, for an audience. Please give them your support and learn about some asynchronous JavaScript.
Yeah, please enjoy. All right, it's time to start about my meetup about Yodongo asynchronous. Thank you for coming today at first. And I'd like to ask several questions at first. How many people is familiar with JavaScript? Oh, most of them. Nice, very cool. And how many people is familiar with asynchronous? Most of them. Cool, thank you so much. Oh, maybe you don't need to learn about asynchronous today. Oh, let's finish today. I'm just kidding. All right. Let's start about I'd like to say thank you at first about Kani and Yan. And thank you for giving me the opportunity to take place my meetup. And thank you for all the staffs, awesome staff supporting me and the team members. I'm talking about Kodokurisais, my cohorts. And yes, I today have my support supporter, who is Alex.
Hello.
Alex, can you introduce yourself?
Briefly, yeah. I'm also a student at Code Chrysalis. I've enjoyed studying here for 11 weeks. Next week is a demo day, so please come out to that if you can. And please enjoy it. Thank you to meet up. If you have any problems, then let me know. Flag me down and I'll give you some help.
All right, thank you so much, Alex. And thank you for everyone for coming today to my meetup. Alright. About me, I'd like to introduce myself a bit. And I am Takahiro Morita. I started my career as an industrial engineer. And while working as an industrial engineer, I got several tasks to automate using programming. So I found programming is so fun. So why don't we don't learn about programming more? So I taught myself about programming. So I changed my career as a SEO specialist to learn to do some tasks in programming. And I thought, this is a good opportunity to change my career as a programmer. And I looked for the job vacancies, but I don't have enough skills. So I had also, what do I do after that? And while thinking about that, I found a post about the Code Chrysalis on Twitter. So I decided to join in Code Chrysalis as a student. And now I'm a student at Code Chrysalis. And this is me. So, and let's talk about the motivation, why I decided about to take place meetup with topic about asynchronous. The reason is while I started as a student at Code Chrysalis, I got several challenges. Even the challenges are tough, I managed to solve them, and everything goes well. But there is the biggest task on week 3, that is about that is about asynchronous about a promise. It was very tough, and I couldn't understand what is happening behind the scenes. The assignment is like you got a program to read in synchronously, and your task, my assignment is like to read writing in asynchronous way, using fallback functions and promises. That was very not intuitive, and I couldn't understand what is happening behind the scenes. And I took maybe 1 week to solve the problem. making try and errors. But at last, I solve it. So today, I'd like to share what is happening behind the scene and what I found when through the assignment. Okay, that's enough about the talk about motivation. Okay, before starting to talk about asynchronous, I want to talk about a synchronous way to write a program. And I want to take a seat make a partner with next to you, and please change your seat, and please discuss about the other, about what is synchronous. Yes. Could you? Yes, you can see. I will give you 2 minutes. And if you get ideas, could you please write down on your whiteboard, and I want to share with you ideas.
Since the program is information is not you don't see things information passing. So like set it to a variable or something. So you know what you want. I want it. Synchronous. So you can like set a command and then JavaScript is synchronous.
Experience and he doesn't know anything about JavaScript or asynchronous, so I was just trying to show him visually
Oh, that's cool. A picture always helps to understand.
Yeah.
We were
just having a conversation about async and sync, but like synchronous is basically waiting until something else is done to go to the next step.
Yeah,
that's cool. Yeah.
And I would like to share my ideas. And let's say that there is a story about you are a customer and you are going to buy your cake in the bakery shop. And at first, you will go to the bakery shop and you will order your cake. I want to buy this whole strawberry cake, that 20,000 yen. And the bakery owner said, okay, this whole strawberry cake and 20,000 yen, it takes 4 hours, is it okay? And the customer said, like, yes, it's okay. And the owner started to cook the cake, preparing the eggs and the flowers, and making sponge cake, and put in the oven, and wait until for 30 or 40 minutes, and pull it back from the oven, and put that cream, and put the strawberries, and put in the box, and say, hey, your cake is ready. And the customer will, do get a notification. And while the customer owner is cooking the cake, what is customer is doing? He is just waiting. Is it understand? It takes 4 hours and he's sleeping. And after that, the customer will receive the cake. This is happening behind the scene when ordering the cake. But do you feel this is natural when you order the cake in real life? I don't think so, because when you order the cake, you can do whatever you want, right? You don't just wait like this. It's a few, sorry, but say that. And let's talk about asynchronous. And I would like to you guys discuss about asynchronous way programming for 2 minutes again. And writing down about whiteboard, and please share the idea. Did you find that? Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's cool.
All that's when you have to just put into one mother's
just think of it as another or another box. After you go into the center box that has all of that functions, then it checks the other box and that callback is going to ask, oh wait, there is something there also. So it distinguishes everything in the first step and the second step, which is a function. There is all that callback.
Hola, it's time to share your ideas. And could you please show up your whiteboard?
It's whiteboard.
Okay. Require read file, join gym, attend meetup, take sad boy yesterday. Require read file, join gym, attend meetup, yes, that's true. And yes, you are same. And
take a gentleman say, take a guess from what I like.
Okay. And the order will start from the first one, and after reading the required FS, it's going to the read file, and after that, it's going to be join gym, since this part is asynchronous working. And after that, it's going to be attend meetup and take picture. And after finishing the reading file part, it's going to be this callback function, and it will go to this 7 or 8. If you get the error message, it's going to be this third error function will be executed. And otherwise, this if check will be executed. This is happening behind the scene asynchronous way. I think you got some ideas. And if you have more asynchronous function to read and do it together, like a check and another check in this space, it's going to be inside of the callback function. But this code has part to take care. And do you have any ideas about what is going to wrong to this code? Do you have any ideas? No? Okay, thank you so much. That's why you are coming here. The first one is it's going to be nested inside the callback function. So it's hard to read, right? It's okay if you understand and write a code, but for other people, if you maintain this code, it's very hard to read. First glance, it's hard to understand. And if you got a bugs in this code, it's very hard to maintain, right? It's going to be nested. So we want to avoid this kind of code to write. How can we avoid? I have no idea. But there is one way. It's about promise. Promise is ES6 feature. ES6 is an ECMAScript 6, which is on 2015 released JavaScript new feature. And why don't we use this feature to write asynchronous code instead of writing this kind of complicated code? And let's see about the promise at first. This say you need to instantiate promise with a new keyword, and inside the promise, it takes callback function with argument, resolve, and reject. And you can read the file as we did previously, and return the resolve function with a picture if you want to handle the successful case. And from promise return the object, so you need to use a then and catch. Is it understand? I don't think so. Very complicated to understand. So let's break down this promise. Promise has three parts to understand. At first, promise return object. And in this object contain the in this object has the status and the value. But status is the promise status, and a value is what you expect to get as a result of the request. And as three status, there are three status in promise, And promise is always one of these three status. One is pending. Pending, you still don't know you can get a value. Like, let's go back to the example with a cake. You just order the cake, and while waiting, you do something else. But in this situation, you still don't know you can get a cake or not, right? So this is a pending situation. The another one is a resolved. Resolved situation, you can successfully, you can get a value. And in with the example with a cake, you can get a cake. And the rejected case, you cannot get a value. And another part to be careful about the promise is then and catch. Since promise return object, to get a value, we need to use a then and catch. Let's go to this three status more. As I said previously, it's like you are queuing up in the several things. Like you're going to buy the food in the McDonald's, and while waiting, you don't know if you can get a value. And about the resolved case, as I said, you can get a cake, what you expected. And the rejected case, like, yeah, this case, sorry man, I decided to close the bakery today, so your cake is totally full bar. Yeah, you cannot buy, you cannot get a cake, what you expected. And now we understand about promise somehow. So let's go back to the code again. Yeah. To write a promise, at first you need to write a new keyword to instantiate. This is okay. It's like a rule to write a promise. And inside the promise, you can take a callback function. And I just write a resolve to make a simplified explain. And in handling the successful case, you can reading the file, and you can get a value, what you expect, inside a resolve function. And again, the promise return object, to get a value, what you expect, you need to use a then and catch. In this case, reading a chat picture file, and to get a chat picture files, you need to use a callback function as an argument of the value, what you expect. And what you can do whatever you want with the picture. And if error happens, if you handle the error case, excuse me, you need to use the catch to get the value. Okay, I think this is somehow understood about the promise. And let's go back about the callback version and the promise version of the call. And let's take a look. And looking at these two calls, and I think we should take time to read about the code. So I will give you the 5 minutes this time. So please read and compare together. Also, if you found anything, yes, you can share with your partners.
That's the point. That's the point. That's the point.
runs actually in function by the same path. So, but the callback could take however long, right? Yeah. So the callback will return back to you. Especially as you're, because there's literally nothing to say. There's no other like offense to it. Like there was no like delete jumps or like go shopping or whatever they so there's nothing else to do.
Keyword and it takes a callback function again and reading a file and you can handle the successful case with a resolve function. Then you can get a value with this pictures argument and there is a new thing is coming, fetch. And the fetch is reading a cake HTTP URL and you can get a value with this then method. And with an argument as a cake, and you can eat a cake, and if you cannot get a value, if the request doesn't successfully executed, the catch will be executed. And the same thing is happening here. And reading file asynchronously with the asynchronous version, and taking a callback function, and if error occurs, this error part will be executed, and if successfully executed, it's going to be else conditions, and it takes request listener function taking the value what we expect. In this case, JSON.parse to get a response text. And if error occurs, this part will be executed. This is very old style, but using an XML HTTP request, you need to write this kind of thing. And how do you feel about these two examples? I think the writing with promise is be more cleaner to write.
This is where this takes a lot.
Gentlemen, do you have any ideas? And I think we are writing the promises more cleaner. And since the fetch method is pop up, so we want to talk about fetch method as well. And do you have any ideas about the fetch? Yes, please.
It's an API call method, so it just goes and like goes to a URL, and if the URL is the API method, it just grabs it.
Wow, excellent. You know very well. Yes, the as you said, the fetch will do the handle the HTTP request with the URL, and it's since the returns a promise object, you need to use a then with to get the value. What we expect in this case, the take and, to iterate, you need to execute this function. This is the way to do the fetch. And I also would like to talk about promise.all method. And does anyone have any ideas what will promise.all do? Does anyone? No? Yeah, thank you. That's okay. And promise.all takes an array of promise. Like in this example, the picture, the have you ever seen this Hachiko statue? It's very, in Japan, it's famous to the location to people will gather to, and after gathering up, the group of people will go somewhere to buy whatever people want. And promise will do the same things. And while the promise is executing, like this first promise, and the second promise, and third promise, and when everyone is gathered up in this Hachiko statue, and it's going to be execute this then method with the result, and you can do whatever you want with this result. And another one is I'd like to talk about the promise.race method. Does anyone have any ideas about the promise.race we do? Okay, thank you. And the promise.race is take, at first, it takes an array of promise, and it's compared to the other, like in this case, turtle.promise and, turtle.promise and rabbit.promise. And when the first promise is completed, the first winner will be executed in this then method as a winner. And in this example, the turtle promise can get a reward as a the prize as a to handle the request. This is the promise of the race do. And this is about everything. And I'd like to share about a summary what we talked today. And we talked about the first time synchronous code. And after that, we talk about the asynchronous code. Then we saw the promise. And after that, we saw the then chaining. And we saw the fetch. And the promise.all. And the last promise.race. This is what we saw today. And thank you so much today for coming to my meetup. And if you have any questions, please. Give me no questions. Yes. Thank you so much. And you still have time to stay here. So please talk and discuss with everyone.